close your restaurant right now. Hello, friends. If you are running a restaurant and you're bleeding out and you're hoping for that new thing to happen, that new lifeline you're gonna get, you're taking on a loan, you are asking for your friends and family for money, you're remortgaging your home, all this kind of stuff just to stay afloat, then unfortunately, I really, really think you should close up your restaurant and cut your losses. And here's why. Friends, I'm telling you this straight from my heart. I get this email a lot. People sharing with me their scenarios, real life people who are struggling to put food on the table. And I just can't muster enough energy to share with them that and tell them that, hey, you know what? It's not gonna work, unfortunately. Either the processes is not there, either the structure is not there, the fundamentals are not there, or the mindset is just not right. And that's the reason why I decided to shoot this video for you, to share with you the three mindset that I see a lot of people struggling from. And without taking care of these three mindsets, there's no way any of these people can be successful. Let's dive right in. The number one mistake that I see people make is letting their ego stand in their way of achieving any type of success. They think they know all that because they've been in the industry for a while. They think they know all that because they're a great cook. They think they know all that because they just think they know all that, without actually having the humility to go out and ask for help, without the humility to go out and learn. For the fact that you're watching this video means that you have the ability to go out there and find resources to better yourself, to help yourself and put yourself in a better situation. And that's the reason why I love my audience, because you guys are the action takers that are willing to do things out of their way and to always improve. And never let your ego stand in the way of you achieving the next level of success. Always go out there and ask for help. Ask people for help. Ask people who have been there, who has done that, to show you the way. So then that way it shortcuts your time to success, and it also shortcuts the money that you're going to be putting in to all the mistakes. So then that way you can build a profitable restaurant. The second mistake that I see a lot of people make are focusing on the sexy stuff. What are the sexy stuff? A lot of times it is marketing. Hey, let's run a Facebook campaign ad. Hey, you know what? Let's work with influencers. Hey, let's do a launch campaign. All these stuff are sexy, it's fun, it's exciting, and it is rewarding. However, these are the things that break your business. Without understanding the full-on strategy, without understanding the milestones, the timelines, the systems, the process, and the fundamentals of what truly makes a restaurant successful, there is no way in hell that you can create a restaurant successfully just by running ads. It just doesn't work like that. Ads is like fuel on a fire. You do not pour fuel on logs of wood without any fire. There won't be any traction. The only time that you want to run ads is when you already have a successful model, a model that your customers are coming in to try out and consistently to try out your food. And then you would want to pour ads into it to keep more and more people to come in through your doors. That's when you run your marketing campaigns. And this is what a lot of people don't want to hear, because they want to focus on the fun stuff, the stuff that you can see, the stuff that you see results right away. That's the reason why a lot of people fail in this business. The third mistake that I see are people staying complacent. They might be running a very successful restaurant for a couple years, but as time goes on, things are developing, things are changing, and the restaurant owner does not innovate as the times change. They do not invest in technology. They do not invest in best practices. They do not train their staff properly. They do not build in a great culture to their business, and they're not adapting to the delivery model. They don't like third-party apps. All this kind of stuff plays into the role of staying complacent. And in today's world, staying complacent is the surest way for you to go down. And that's the reason why a lot of restaurateurs fail, is because they stick to their own ways of doing things. They're not innovating. If you want to succeed in today's world, it's even more important that you bring on the best practices to see what is working in the world today, not half a year ago, not pre-COVID, but in today's world. What is working? Go out there and find all the strategies that are working in today's world and implement it into your business. Because without you doing that, without you adapting, you are just going to be able to run your restaurant to the ground. So there you go, friends. My heartfelt message to all of you guys out there. The three mistakes that people are making that is keeping them in a dark, dark hole. And if you find yourself taking these mistakes or guilty of them, then maybe really consider closing down your restaurant and start fresh again to make sure you avoid the mistakes that I'm sharing with you right now. Don't let your ego stand in your way of any type of success. Don't just focus on the short term, the sexy stuff, the marketing stuff. Focus on the foundation, the things that are actually going to make your business. And don't be complacent. Be innovative and work with the times. And if this is something that you are dedicated into making sure that, hey, this is what I want, then I invite you to our live masterclass very, very soon, happening in November. Check it out in the link below. In this masterclass, it's an hour-long lesson where I share with you the foundations, the principles, and the systems of what truly makes a restaurant successful. Attend it completely for free, and hopefully you're going to be able to find some value to help out your restaurant. Once again, thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button, subscribe along the journey, and I'll see you guys in the live masterclass.